In previous lesson, we discussed various measures of central tendencies. The aim of this lesson is to make you understand a measure of dispersion called standard deviation and the graphic presentation of data. On the completion of this lesson, you should be able to compute standard deviation and prepare various graphs and charts. In social work research, we often wish to know the extent of homogeneity and heterogeneity among respondents with respect to a given characteristic. In fact, the extent to which they vary among themselves is of basic importance in statistics. Measures of central tendency describe one important characteristic of a set of data, typicality, but they do not tell us anything about homogeneity and heterogeneity among respondents. Consequently, we need ways of measuring homogeneity or heterogeneity, the extent to which data are dispersed. These are called measures of dispersion or variability. One of the important measures of dispersion or variability is called standard deviation. The procedure of calculating standard deviation is described below. Standard deviation, the most useful and frequently used measure of dispersion, is standard deviation or root mean squared deviation about the mean. The standard deviation is defined as the square root of the arithmetic mean of the squares of the deviation about the mean. Symbolically, where sigma, Greek letter sigma, stand for standard deviation, D2 for the sum of squares of the deviation measured from mean, and N for number of items. Calculation of standard deviation in series of individual observation. Table 1, marks obtained by students. First column presents roll numbers. Second column, marks obtained by individual students are presented. Table 2, first column gives roll number of students. Second column gives marks obtained by each students. Third column gives deviation from mean 49. Last column is square of deviation, D square. We calculate deviation by subtracting the mean from the marks obtained as 31 minus 49. We get minus 18. 35 minus 49. We get minus 14. 38 minus 49, we get minus 11. 41 minus 49, minus 8. 49 minus 49, 0. 54 minus 49, plus 5. 59 minus 49, plus 10. 66 minus 49, plus 17. 68 minus 49, plus 19. Then we take the squares of deviations, that is, the first student's deviation is minus 18. We multiply it by minus 18, so we get D square, that is 324. Similarly, square of minus 14 is 196, square of 11 is 121, square of 8 is 64, 0 will be 0, 5 square is 25, square of 10 is 100, square of 17 is 289, square of 19 is 361. The mean is 441 by 9 equals to 49. Then total square of deviation is equals to 1480. Sigma equals to square root of summation of D square by N equals to square root of 1480 divided by 9. By solving this, we get square root of 164.444 is 12.82 approximately. Table 3, shortcut method. First column of this table gives the roll number. Second column is marks obtained. Third column gives deviation from assumed mean is 41. Then we take the square of d square, square of deviations. If our assumed mean is 41, the deviation we obtain by subtracting it from first observation, that is 31. Hence, 31 minus 41 is equals to minus 10. The square of minus 10 is 100. 35 minus 41 minus 6, square of 6 is 36. 38 minus 41 minus 3, square of minus 3 is 9. 41 minus 41, 0, square is 0. 49 minus 41 plus 8, square of 8 is 64. 54 minus 41 plus 13, square of 13 is 169. 59 minus 41 is equals to 18, square of 18 is 324. 66 minus 41, 25, square of 25 is 625. 68 minus 41 is 27, square of 27 is 729. Total number of observation is 9. Summation of D is 72. Summation of D square is 2056. The formula for shortcut method is sigma equals to square root of summation of D square by N minus summation D by N whole square. Putting the values, square root of 2056 by 9 minus 72 by 9 whole square. Solving, next we get square root of 228.44 minus 64. Square root of 164.44 is 12.82. We get the same result as we have got in direct method. Calculation of a standard deviation in discrete series. In a discrete series, the deviation from an assumed mean are first computed and multiplied by the respective frequencies of items. These products are total and divided by the total of frequencies. The standard deviation is calculated with the help of following formula. Sigma equals to square root of summation of FD square by N minus summation of FD by N whole square. The following illustration would explain the formula. Table 4, gain in weight of 65 children during a specified period. First column of the table gives gain in kilogram of 9 children. Second column gives the frequencies of children. The total frequency is 65. Table 5 shows the procedure of calculating standard deviations. First column shows gain in kilogram, second number of children. Third column shows deviation from the assumed mean. Let us suppose the assumed mean is 5. Next column gives you total deviation, then is a squared of the deviation, and then frequency multiplied by squared of deviation. To calculate deviations, we subtract the assumed mean from the individual observation. 1 minus 5 is minus 4. 2 minus 5, minus 3. 3 minus 5, minus 2. 4 minus 5, minus 1. 5 minus 5, 0. 6 minus 5, plus 1. 7 minus 5, plus 2. 8 minus 5, plus 3. 9 minus 5, plus 4. Now, we multiply the deviation with the frequency. So, minus 4 multiplied by 3, we get minus 12. Minus 3 multiplied by 4, minus 12. 6 into minus 2, minus 12. 9 into minus 1, minus 9. 12 into 0, 0. 11 into 1, 1. 9 into 2, 18. 7 into 3, 21. 4 into 4, 16. Now, we square the deviations. First observation deviation is minus 4. Square of minus 4 is 16. Second observation is minus 3. Square of minus 3 is 9. Third observation is minus 2. Square of minus 2 is 4. Minus 1 square is 1, 0, 0. 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16. Now we multiply this with the frequency. 16, the first frequency is 3. Squared, first squared deviation is 16. So we multiply, we get 48. Second is 4 frequency, 9 squared deviation, 36. 6 into 4, 24. 9 into 1, 9. 12 into 0, 0. 11 into 1, 11. 9 into 4, 36. 7 into 9, 63. 4 into 16, 64. The total frequency is 65. Summation of product of frequency and deviation is 21. Summation of frequency and square of deviation is 291. The formula is standard deviation or sigma equals to square root of summation of FD square by N minus summation of FD by N whole square equals to square root of 291 divided by 65 minus 21 divided by 65 whole square. 291 divided by 65 is equals to 4.4769, and 21 divided by 65, and the square of that comes to 0.1044. Subtracting 0.1044 from 4.4769, we get 4.3725. Square root of 4.3725 is 2.09 approximately. Calculation of standard deviation in continuous series. In a continuous series, the class intervals are represented by their midpoints. However, usually the class intervals are of equal size, and thus the deviations from the assumed average is expressed in class interval units. Alternatively, step deviation is found out by dividing the deviations by the magnitude of the class intervals. Thus, the formula for computing standard deviation is written as follows, where I stands for the common factor or the magnitude of class interval. The following example would illustrate this formula. Table 6 presents weekly family income of 8 respondents in rupees. Second column gives weekly income in class intervals. Third column gives number of families. Table 7. Second column gives weekly income. Third column gives mid value of the class interval. Fourth is number of families. Fifth is step deviation from assumed average. Sixth is frequency into deviation. Seven is deviation square. Last column is frequency into deviation square. First, we have to calculate mid values. The mid value of the class 100 to 200, we calculate by adding the two limits divided by 2. That is 100 plus 200 divided by 2. That is 150. Similarly, mid value of second class will be 250. Third class will be 350. Fourth will be 450, 550, 650, 750, and the last class mid value will be 850. Next, we calculate the step deviation from the assumed average, let us say 450, and then we divide it by class interval to get the step deviation. That is 150 minus 450 equals to 300. The class interval is 300 divided by 100 is minus 3. Multiplied by frequency, we get minus 15. The square of deviation is 9. Deviation into square of deviation is 9 into 5, 45. Similarly, for second class, the mid value is 250. You subtract 450, we get 200. We divide it by 100 to get step deviation, that is minus 2. Multiply it by number of families, the frequency, we get minus 12. The square of step deviation is minus 2 into 2, 4. Now we multiply square of the deviation and the frequencies, we get 24. For third class, 350 minus 450, we get 100. Divide by 100, we get minus 1. Multiply by 15, we get minus 15. Square of deviance is minus 1 into minus 1, 1. Then frequency into square of deviation is minus 15 into 1, 15. 0, 0, and 0. 550 minus 450 is 100. Divide by 100 is 1. Frequency is 5, so product of frequency and deviation is 5. Square of deviation is 1. Then frequency and square of deviation is 5. Next, 650 minus 450, 200. Divided by 100, 2. Multiplied by frequency, that is 4, so we get 8. D square will be 4. Now we multiply D square with the frequency, that is 4 into 4, 16. 750 minus 450, 300 divided by 100, we get step deviation 3. Square of the step deviation is 9. And square of deviation multiplied by frequency is 3 into 9 equals to 27. 850 minus 450 is 400, divided by 100, we get 4. Then multiply by frequency, that is 2, so we get 8. Then we take the D square. D is 4, so D square will be 16. 16 multiplied by 2 is 32. Now, total number of frequency is 50. Summation of product of frequency and deviation is minus 12. Summation of frequency and deviation square is 164. The above explanation can be presented in a summary table as given below. Step 1, find the midpoints of the various classes, 100 plus 200 by 2, 300 by 2 equals to 150. Second step, assume a midpoint as average, preferably at the center. Let us say 450 we have taken. Take the differences of each midpoint from the assumed average and divide them by the magnitude of the class interval to get step deviation. 150 minus 450 equals to minus 300 by 3 minus 3. Fourth step, the deviations are multiplied by the frequency of each class. Minus 3, 5, minus 15, minus 2, 6, 12. Next step is find the aggregate of the products of a step deviation, that is summation of FD. Summation FD is minus 12. Square the deviations, D square, minus 3 into minus 3, 9. Square deviations are multiplied by the respective frequencies, that is FD square, 9 into 5, 45. Find the aggregate of the products of a step deviation, 7, summation of FD square, that is 164. Now we can compute standard deviation with the help of formula. Formula of standard deviation is square root of summation of FD square by N minus summation of FD by N whole square into I. We put the values obtained in the table we have shown. Then we get square root of 3.28 minus 0.0578 into 100. Then we get 1.795 into 100. Equals to 179.51 approximately. Graphic presentation of data. A graph or chart is a graphic presentation of a set of data. Graphs and charts must be accurate and convey information efficiently. Ideally, graphs will also be aesthetically pleasing. There are different types of graphs and charts. Some of the commonly used graphs and charts are 1. Bar diagrams, 2. Histograms, and 3 pie charts. Bar diagrams. A bar chart or bar graph is a chart with rectangular bars with lengths proportional to the values that they represent. The bars can be plotted vertically or horizontally. A vertical bar chart is sometimes called a column bar chart. A bar graph is a chart that uses either horizontal or vertical bars to show comparisons among categories. One axis of the chart shows the specific categories being compared, and other axis represents a discrete value. Figure 1, status of educational level before camp. A graph is drawn on a graph sheet, and we draw first two axes, that is x-axis and y-axis. The horizontal line is called as x-axis, vertical line is called y-axis. Now we have to fix the units by seeing the total number of frequencies. Now here it is 1 square equals to 2 units in the y-axis, that you can see 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. The y-axis gives you the enrollment in a particular class. So each rectangular bar shows the standard. So you can see not enrolled, third standard, fourth standard, fifth standard, sixth standard, seventh standard like. And now it's very easy to see the trend. We find that most of the children had fifth standard level of education before they joined the camp, and very few joined the camp at fourth standard and tenth standard. A bar chart is very useful for recording certain information, whether it is continuous or not continuous data. Histograms. A histogram is a graphical presentation showing a visual impression of the distribution of data. A histogram consists of tabular frequencies shown as adjacent rectangles erected over discrete intervals. With an area equal to the frequency of the observation in the interval. The height of a rectangle is also equal to the frequency density of the interval, that is, the frequency divided by width of the interval. Figure 2 shows a histogram, and it shows the age distribution of the children in the camp. Here, x-axis shows age of children, y-axis shows frequency of the children. Now here unit is 10, that is 1 square of the graph is 10 units, 10, it represents 10 children. X-axis, the square represents 2, it starts from 8, so 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. Now we can see that the majority of the children were around 16 years with a standard deviation of 1.78. The difference in bar chart and histogram is bar diagram, all rectangles represent a frequency independently. In histogram, the bar is not separated. They give the cumulative frequencies. So we find here a kind of continuous line. Pie chart. A pie chart is a circular chart divided into sectors, illustrating proportion. In a pie chart, there are length of each sector and consequently its central angle and area that is proportional to the quantity in it represents. When angles are measured with one turn a unit, then a number of percent is identified with the same number of cent turns. Together, the sectors create an angle of 360 degree. It is named for its resemblance to a pie which has been sliced. The size of the sectors is calculated by converting between the percentages and degree or by use of a percentage protractor. See figure 3. Figure 3, pie chart. The pie chart is perhaps the most widely used statistical chart in research studies. However, it has been criticized and some recommended avoiding it, pointing out in particular it is difficult to compare different sections of a given pie chart or to compare data across different pie charts. Pie charts can be an effective way of displaying information in some cases. In particular, if the intent is to compare the size of a slice with the whole pie rather than comparing the slices among them. Pie chart work particularly well when the slices represent 25 to 50% of the data. Summary. One of the important measures of dispersion or variability is called standard deviation. It is the most useful and frequently used measure of dispersion. The standard deviation is defined as the square root of the arithmetic mean of the square of the deviations about the mean. A graph or chart is a graphic presentation of a set of data. There are different types of graphs and charts. Some of the commonly used graphs and charts are bar diagrams, histograms, and pie charts. Frequently asked questions. What is the purpose of measure of dispersion? What are the different types of graphs and charts? References. Ellens D.N. 1984, Fundamentals of Statistics, Allahabad Kitab Mahal. Garrett H.E. 1966, Statistics in Physical and Education, Bombay, Wakils. Gupta S.P. 1980, Statistical Methods, New Delhi, S. Chand. Krishep Curtis H. 1987, Fundamentals of Statistics for Human Services and Social Work, Boston, Duxbury Press. Laldas D.K. 2000, Practice of Social Research, A Social Work Perspective, Jaipur Rawat Publications. Philip A. and others, 1975, Social Work Research and Analysis of Social Data, Oxford Paragon Press.